Good evening, this is Ash, and welcome to my latest model train review video. Tonight, I've decided to make a remake of my Class 60 review video that I did over a year ago in standard definition. This model is 60078 that was released in 2006. It is DCC ready, as you can see by the hologram there, and this is a super detailed model to come from Hornby. And in my opinion, it is by far the best ready to run 00 gauge model of a Class 60 available anywhere. Right, we just turn the box around. As you can see on the side, the reference number is R2490, Mainline CO-CO, diesel electric Class 60 locomotive of 60078. Now that we've covered the outside and the details, let's open up the box and let's have a look inside as to what you get with the model. Firstly, let's cover the instructions and the DCC decoder insulation sleeve. This is supplied with all DCC ready class, correction, DCC ready locomotives, which could be steam, diesel, or electric, and even units. So, depending on the model train you buy that's DCC ready by Hornby, you may get more than one of these. So we'll just pop that to one side. I will point out that most modern decoders are pre-insulated. So the DCC insulating sleeve for the decoder may not be necessary. Next, let's have a look at the instructions. In this diagram on the left, this tells you how to apply or remove the NEM tension lock coupler, and also options to add the flush snow plough, also known as the air dam, complete with the brake pipes and the cosmetic screw link coupler. Excuse me. In this diagram, if you wish to fit a DCC decoder, the body on this locomotive just simply unclips from the die-cast chassis. And also in the third paragraph, this tells you how to lubricate the bearings and which parts of the model should be lubricated. This diagram, this tells you about the switch on the fuel tank should you wish to switch between day and night settings. I apologise if my voice is not the best today, as the pollen is pretty high, and as I suffer from hay fever, it may impair the performance of my narration, so I do apologise for that. But sticking with the model, simple access to this model is by removing the two end clips, as I will point out that this is a two partition polystyrene tray. In the top left hand side, I've left one of the NEM couplers placed on the top for easy access when I run this train. But nonetheless, the whole top part lifts off, and underneath the tissue wrap, this is the beast, 60078. So, just bear with me for 1 second. Oops. Before I do, I will just briefly show you the accessories that you get in the sachet, which is your air dams. I've already fitted a decoder into the model, so this is the blanking plug for the DCC circuit board. But also in there somewhere you should be able to see some brake pipes and the cosmetic screw link couplers that I've previously mentioned when I was covering the instructions. But likewise, that's the accessories and the packaging covered. So I'll just clean up the area and then I shall take the model off the stand and place it on the track. There will be a test drive following on from this part of the video, which will be on an oval track. But I will give a word of warning when handling this model from the packaging. The horns on top of this model are very, very fragile, so care must be taken when handling the model, when removing it or putting it in the box. Excuse me. Please excuse the fingers whilst I place the model on the track. Just move all the packaging out of the way, and now we can have some close-ups. Just like you'd expect with the majority of high-quality models from Hornby, this Class 60, again please excuse the fingers, also has sprung buffers. Both of these are sprung. The doors open. You've got nice etched grills on the sides. My example of this Class 60 has been retrofitted with a Fox Transfer EWS Beastie. But sticking with the model, you've also got etched grills on the roof. Nice amount of riveting, complete with some additional vents, which are all etched onto the model, by the way. You've got a catenary warning sign above the engine room doors. Nice amount of detail on the fuel tank. Complete with some footsteps fitted onto the trucks as well. Excuse me. This is the compressor, which charges up the air tanks. And also, whilst moving down the side of the model, there is another grill as well. And you've also got detailing on the exhaust pod as well. Sorry about the pause in the video, I've just sneezed again and I don't really want that actually on the final recording, but carrying on where I've just briefly stopped the video, you've also got a nicely detailed exhaust pod, some additional rivets and another ventilation grill on the roof. You've got the secondary grill, as well as additional detailing on the trucks. And just like with the other door, this one also opens and closes as well. And you've also got some etched air horns on the top there, along with the GPS radio pod. So, I think that's all there is to cover on this Class 60. There will be a test drive to follow shortly, and then I shall bring this review to a close with a final score and an overview. So I will be back shortly. Stay tuned. Welcome back. Now that I've placed the model of 60078 on the test track, this video will now resume with a test drive. Bear in mind that this locomotive has not been ran for a while, so it may need a warm-up of a couple of laps. And there is a Lenz Silver Decoder fitted on board this model locomotive as well. So, we shall head forwards. The lighting is quite bright, so if there is any blur on the camera, I do apologise for this in advance. But meanwhile, enjoy the review and the test run. Currently trying my best to keep up with the model, as it does tend to accelerate quite fast on some parts of the test loop, and it runs quite slow on others. But as you can see, it's a very smooth runner. I've currently got the power on just under 50%, which is around running in speed. But I'm going to fix the camera in this position just for the time being. And now I shall stop the locomotive and I will change direction and bring the locomotive towards you, which cab number 2 will be facing the camera. Currently on 50% power. And as you can see in the video, it is warming up nicely, so response is improving. So once the motor has warmed up from its lengthy storage, performance should improve. Excuse me. Price wise, it depends on where you shop, and it also depends on if you can still buy this model brand new or a used example, but expect to pay anything from as low as £50, anything up to £120 for a non-DCC sound Hornby Class 60. Due to obvious reasons, the sound equipped Class 60s will cost significantly more, but the sounds are very impressive on those, and I do have a sound equipped Class 60 that I will review in a later video in the year. But meanwhile, I shall just stop the video out of view, correction, I shall just stop the locomotive out of view of the video, and I shall now go the other way. And I shall try and follow the locomotive around the loop with a couple of passes, and then I shall bring this review and test run of the Hornby Class 60 to a close. Just add a bit of juice to the track to help the locomotive respond a bit better. Well, that concludes the test drive review and overview of the Hornby Class 60, which this example is 60078 in the Mainline aircraft blue livery. Albeit, my example is a modified version with an EWS beastie. For detail, performance and value, I give this locomotive a perfect 10 out of 10. And that concludes the review. Or the remake, should I say. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to post them in the comment section below. And thank you for watching. Please feel free to give feedback, as all positive and constructive feedback will be most welcome on this remake. And stay tuned for another video coming soon. Have a good week.